Hello YouTube, Beanie from the bedroom here, your guitar junkie, one take Beanie. This is it. So, I just want to make sure, I've never counted really. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, so I happen to have 9 Harley Benton guitars. I'm not bragging. It's a sickness, it's a disease. If you care to donate just $1 a week, you'll help people like me to stop buying guitars. I think I have like 9, not all these 9, a total I think I have. Because I have other guitars that I don't play anymore. Different brands. I think I got a total of 9 guitars as it is on Craigslist for sale. Like I said, if I don't pick it up and play it all the time, I don't hold on to it. I'm not a collector. My go-tos, if I had to pick 3, there would be 3 different brands, 3 different styles for 3 different reasons. However, the topic of the day is, what are my top 3 Harley Benton guitars that I absolutely love of all time? Well, let's see, what do we start with? All right, let's start with this here, SG. Yep, it's a honey, sweet guitar. Looks like it's an ebony fingerboard. I don't know, I'm not gonna say, because I had someone yell at me about the, if you don't do more research on a guitar, then don't have an opinion. But that's all it is an opinion. I'm not giving you facts and figures. I don't have a piece of paper in front of me. I'm going by my memory, and my memory is toast. So, this is your SG style. And, I put locking tuners on it. I put a roller bridge, and I put this Duesenberg tremolo system on it. Because how cool is it to have an SG with a tremolo system? 24 frets. So, I'm going to just, not for any particular reason, I'm going to save my top 3 for 3, 2, 1. So I'm just going to go in whatever order that I just have them laid out. This is your SG model. If you always wanted an SG, a double horn, and I've had a couple of Gibsons and I never kept them, I love this one. I just love it. I don't know why. I always wanted an SG other than a Stratocaster or a Gibson. And I finally have one that's cool as all heck. Next one is this Harley Benton Telecaster. Yeah, I did put locking tuners on it. I did put the oil on the neck. And this has P90 pickups, and it, again, it's the same kind of, it looks like it's ebony, but it's that Purple Heart kind of thing. I think the other one was baked. And this is semi-hollow body, quilted maple top, and it just looks stunning, even though it's got fingerprints all over it. I'm just trying to keep myself from having that OCD moment all the time. So yeah, there's one. Over here, we've got Gold Top. Single cut LP, vintage style tuners. Looks like, again, like an ebony fingerboard. These fingerboards are sweet, man. They have a good brown sound to them. And they're slick, and you can't beat it. This has, so they all have Roswell pickups. These are open covered Roswell, and the other two were just plain Roswell. So this is all satin finish, and it's a monster of a guitar. It's what you can call a workhorse. And then, pardon me for getting up. I don't have an assistant here today because she's got a ton of homework. Another Harley Benton Telecaster, semi-hollow body with a Roswell stacked pickup. that if you've seen the video on it, it's just amazing. A roasted maple neck and fingerboard, I believe it was Canadian wood. It's slightly, you got to get it on the right angle, but it's slightly bird's eye maple in the front. Cold tap, and butterscotch, 69 version. It's like a hot rod at 69. Put that puppy down. Got the Brian May style. This is, I believe this was a BM 75 Deluxe. So you've got your Grover tuners on the back. Again, I think it's the Amaranth Purple Heart fingerboard. It looks like ebony. It's got that good dark brown sound to it. 24 frets. Tremolo system. It's set up as a floater. You could always put a coin in there, or you could block it from the rear, or you could, just hardtail it all the way down if you don't want to be dealing with a tremolo system. You've got your phases here, so you've got a coil tap, five-way, for the three chrome-plated Roswell pickups. And you have phasing, so it's not tapping because it's single coil, it's just changing the polarity, volume and tone. So this is just easy access to the lower frets. And yes, it's got some dust on it, sorry. If you're a Queen fan or Brian May fan, you know, this is the guitar for you. Then, this LP, Harley Benton single cut. What I call blood red. I'll try to put a description of every guitar in the description box, hence the name description. Gold plated hardware, Tesla plated pickups, 22 medium jumbo stainless steel blacksmith frets, and I forget the kind of fingerboard. I do apologize. It's super light. My only beef, and I've had a couple people say the same thing, the fingerboard should be darker. So if I were to hold on to this and keep and change the strings, I would definitely stain the fingerboard darker. Someone might like that. You know, it just doesn't, I don't like it. Okay, that's all I got to say about that. That's my speech, and I'm sticking to it. Some people might think that looks cool because it's a contrast to the dark body. You have a light colored wood. I just think it should be darker. That's all. But that's just me. So, did I leave any out? Did I miss any? Oh yeah, right here. I forgot this puppy. So. Number three, counting down, because I'm sure I got everything at this point. Yes. So, this just reminds me, if you see the picture in the bottom, when you're watching the video, it's the bottom right side of the video. It's a picture of me, very dusty again, sorry. I had a guitar very similar to this with the shape, with four chrome plated pickups. It had like a kind of whammy bar on it. And I played that guitar when I got it. I think it was like 14, 15 when I got the guitar. And I just played that guitar every day as I did the other one. The other one, the acoustic, you know, kind of like hung up on a wall and was never touched again once I got an electric guitar. And this reminds me a lot of it, but this is the copy of the Redenbacher. And some of my hollow body, two volumes and tones, three-way, Roswell, it's like a mini humbucker pickup. With the beautiful, again, it looks like it's ebony, the fingerboard, but it's got that dark brown sound to it. And this is my number three out of all my Harley Bentons because It just it reminds me of my first electric guitar. It's got that 60s vintage, you know, kind of look to it, and the nostalgia that it brings to me, you know, just, you know, fills my heart with joy. So this would be number three. Number two. Yeah, I grabbed this a lot. This is the Harley Benton single cut LP. Vintage tuners. I do have a set of with the vintage knobs on the end, but they're locking tuners. So when I do change the strings, I will change the tuners. You know why. This has Tesla open pickups that just, they're beastly pickups. Beastly, Mom. Just simply beastly. The only thing I did was I changed the knobs because I like the fatter knobs. So this is the AAA Tiger Maple veneer, and it's the resembles Slash's guitar. It's got the cutaway here, flute on the back. I think every guitar has that, should have that. And it's chambered like the red one. I didn't mention, but the red one's chambered too. So it's weight restricted. So they have little chambers in there. And I grab this thing a lot when it comes to Harley Benton guitars. So that's number two. My number one, because it's just so unique and different from everything else, is this one here. So this is a roasted Tiger Maple neck and fingerboard, and again, it's hard to see the stripes because of the light. This came with original Grover locking tuners, graphite nut like the other two LPs, semi-hollow body, coiled tap, big deal, three-way, and this has covered Tesla pickups. And it's the first roasted neck that's been on a set neck guitar, not a bolt-on. So this is, I get so much out of this. I always liked the 335s, and I had a couple, and I never kept them. And I like the way they sound and they play, but they're just so big. It's just, even though they're thinner than this body, they're bigger and rounder, and I feel like I'm hugging a bear. So, you know, I just don't grab it all too often. So I never keep them. And let's see what we have here. This is like my clean channel with my dirty Shirley. Because I figured, let's just play out with my number one Harley Benton guitar.
about timing, and I missed a count, so I didn't know when that was going to stop. So I just figured I stop it before it stops me, right? Be one step ahead of it. So, yeah, I don't remember. I may have. I know I did a jazz thing. I think I did a rock thing with this guitar. But now I want to do a blues thing with it. And just to show that this is like a, you could do anything you want with this guitar. You could split it and get that Fender. That split. And I'm using the Brutus, Kayleen, I think it's called, as the overdrive. It's to me, it's equivalent to a tube screamer. So, you know, without it, this is the clean channel, but like I said, I have to turn the gain up. So it breaks up a little bit. Split. Yeah, see how you lose the volume? You don't get that on the telly with the stacked single coil pickup. Yeah, so that's the clean as it can be, the chord. See? It's not crispy clean, but, you know, it's like a speaker that's wearing out in a very old amp. Like the cardboard is starting to separate. So, that's it. Yeah. Hope you enjoyed the video. Have a good day and a better tomorrow. Let's hope this thing works. 1, 2, 3.